गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, फ्रॉम टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर 3, दैट इज़ सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स एंड प्लास्टिक्स। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द फाइबर्स, दैट इज़ द नेचुरल फाइबर एंड द सिंथेटिक फाइबर एंड प्लास्टिक्स। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड सी दैट वॉट डू वी मीन बाय द वर्ड फाइबर्स। ओके, what do we mean by the word fiber? Let us first read the definition. The cloths which we wear are made from fabrics. We know that in different seasons we wear different kind of cloths, right? In winter season we wear woolen cloths, while in summer season we wear cotton cloths. So the different cloths are made up of different fabrics, right? And that fabrics are made up from fibers. Okay, so the different kind of cloths that we wear in different seasons are made from different kind of fibers, and these fibers are obtained to us by two resources, that is the natural source and the artificial source. Okay, so what do we mean by these natural sources of fiber and artificial sources of fiber? This we will see in our next slide. Okay, so how will we define fibers? Fibers is nothing but several fibers can give us the fabric, and that fabric is used to make the cloths that we wear. Okay, and not only the cloths but several other things also. First of all we will see what do we mean by natural fiber. Okay, so as its name suggests, something which is natural something which we obtain from nature is called natural, right? So we can define natural fiber as the fibers which we obtain from nature are called natural fibers. Okay, for example, we know that cotton, as we can see in this figure also, the cotton we get from the plant, and plant is obviously the natural resource, right? So cotton is such a fiber which we get from nature. That's why cotton is said to be natural fiber. Okay, similarly we know that this silk we get from silkworm, right? And silkworm is an insect. That's why silk is also said to be a natural fiber. Okay students, so we can define natural fibers as the fibers which we obtain from nature are called natural fibers. And what are the examples of natural fibers? The examples of natural fiber are cotton and silk. Okay, now opposite to that of natural fiber we have artificial fibers here. What are these artificial fibers? The fibers that are made by humans artificially are called artificial fibers. Okay, something which cannot be obtained naturally but we have to make it by our own is said to be artificial. Okay, so what are the artificial fibers? Rayon, nylon, all these are the examples of artificial fibers. Okay, in rainy season we wear raincoat, right? The raincoat consists of a specific kind of fiber, and that fiber is also a man-made fiber. Okay, so the fibers which are not obtained naturally but a man can make it artificially are called the artificial fibers. Okay students, now in this chapter we will study the artificial fibers in detail. Okay, first of all we should know that what are artificial or synthetic fibers. Okay, artificial fibers are also known as synthetic fibers. First of all we should know that what does it means actually. So as you can see in this figure, here is a necklace of pearls, right? Here a necklace of pearls is given as we can see here. This necklace consists of several so many pearls, right? Similarly, a synthetic fiber is also made up of several small units which are joined together. Okay, as we can see in this figure that this necklace is made up of so many pearls, so many identical pearls. Similarly, a synthetic fiber is also made up of so many small units which are joined together to form a fiber. Okay, and these small units are nothing but a chemical substance. Okay, as it is not a natural thing, so it has to be formed chemically. Okay, so what are these single units? These single units are made up of chemicals, and these are said to be the chemical substances. Okay, how do we get the synthetic fiber? Many small units combine to form a large single unit, and that is said to be polymer. Okay, several small units which are identical combine together to form a single unit, and that single unit is called as polymer. The word polymer is composed of two words, that is poly and mer. Poly means many and mer means part, right? So what do we mean by polymer? Something which consists of many parts, right? So simply we can understand it, a polymer consists of so many identical parts that are called as monomers. Okay, several identical parts combine to form a large unit, and that large unit is called as polymer, and the several small units are said to be monomers. Okay, now we are going to study about the types of synthetic fiber. There are so many types of synthetic fiber. Here we are going to discuss some of them. First one is rayon or artificial silk. First we will read that what is given to us in our slide. Rayon is made up from wood pulp, yet it is a man made fiber. Okay, why it is called as artificial silk? Because the pure silk is so costly. As we get the silk from the saliva of the silkworm, so it is not found in abundance. There is a scarcity of it, right? And as there is a scarcity of it, so it is very costly. We cannot afford a pure silk. So to replace the pure silk, we need an artificial silk which is made chemically or artificially, and that artificial silk is called as rayon. Okay, that rayon is made from wood pulp, and so many other things are also combined with the wood pulp to form the rayon, and that's why it is called man-made fiber, because it is made by human being artificially. Okay, rayon is cheaper than silk, and it can be woven as silk. The rayon, as you can see in the figure also, students, rayon slightly looks like silk also, and it is cheaper than silk. So the silk sarees also that you have seen, na, so that that all are made from rayon only, that all are made from rayon, and that all are not pure silk. Okay, next is rayon is mixed with cotton to make the bed sheets, and mixed with wool to make carpets. Okay, rayon ko jab hum cotton ke sath mix karte hain, so we can make bed sheets with them, and when it is mixed with wool, then carpets can be made from that. Okay students, so proceeding ahead, द नेक्स्ट काइंड ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल फाइबर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज नायलॉन. एज यू कैन सी इन द फिगर दैट दिस नायलॉन इज यूज टू मेक रोप्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी दैट वॉट इज नायलॉन. नायलॉन इज प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम कोल, वॉटर एंड एयर. नायलॉन इज एन आर्टिफिशियल फाइबर विच इज फॉर्म्ड बाय कोल, वॉटर एंड एयर. इट इज स्ट्रॉन्ग, इलास्टिक एंड लाइट. जो नायलॉन का धागा होता है, इट इज़ ऑल्सो यूज टू फ्लाई द काइट्स ऑल्सो, राइट. हम जो पतंग उड़ाते हैं उसमें हम नायलॉन का धागा भी यूज़ करते हैं. सो यू ऑल हैव सीन दैट नायलॉन थ्रेड, राइट. दैट इज़ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, इट इज़ काइंड ऑफ इलास्टिक ऑल्सो, एंड इट इज़ लाइट वेट, है ना. इट इज़ नॉट दैट हैवी, सो इट इज़ लाइट वेट. इट इज़ लश्चरस एंड ईजी टू वॉश. दीज आर सम ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नायलॉन फैब्रिक, ओके, नायलॉन फाइबर. नाउ व्हाट आर द यूजेस ऑफ नायलॉन. नायलॉन इज यूज टू मेक सॉक्स, रोप्स एंड कार सीट बेल्ट्स, ओके. द फाइबर दैट इज यूज टू मेक द सॉक्स इज नथिंग बट नायलॉन. सिमिलरली एज यू कैन सी इन द फिगर, दिस रोप्स आर मेड अप ऑफ नायलॉन एंड द कार सीट बेल्ट. द सीट बेल्ट ऑफ कार आर ऑल्सो मेड अप ऑफ नायलॉन, ओके. नाउ द नेक्स्ट काइंड ऑफ फाइबर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज पॉलीस्टर, ओके. सो फैब्रिक विच मेड फ्रॉम दिस फाइबर डू नॉट गेट रिंकल्ड इजीली, ओके. पॉलीस्टर इज ऑल्सो अ काइंड ऑफ फैब्रिक. एंड वॉट इज द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ फैब्रिक. इट इज़ दैट द फैब्रिक्स विच आर मेड अप फ्रॉम दिस काइंड ऑफ फाइबर डू नॉट गेट रिंकल्ड ईजीली, ओके. रिंकल का मतलब क्या कि इस फाइबर से जो फैब्रिक्स बनते हैं उनमें आसानी से सल नहीं आते हैं. दैट्स वाई पॉलीस्टर इज यूज टू मेक द टी शर्ट्स, द शर्ट्स एंड ऑल दैट, ओके. एज यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम दैट द टी शर्ट इज मेड अप ऑफ पॉलीस्टर, ओके स्टूडेंट्स. इट रिमेन्स क्रिस्प एंड इट इज़ ईजी टू वॉश. Also the polyester is easy to wash, that's why we prefer to wear the polyester cloths, okay. Now PET, that is polyethylene terephthalate, is a very familiar form of polyester, okay. This PET is one kind of polyester. And what is the use of this kind of polyester? It is used in making bottles, utensils, wires, etc. Okay, students, as I have told you in the beginning of the lecture, that not only the clothes are made up of artificial fibers, hai na? We can make another things also with the help of artificial fibers and bottles, utensils, wires. All are the examples of such kind of things, okay. Now the next kind of artificial fiber that we are going to study is acrylic. What do we mean by acrylic? The shawls, sweaters and the blankets are not actually made from natural wool, okay. जो शॉल, स्वेटर्स, ब्लैंकेट्स हम लोग पहनते हैं, दैट आर नॉट एक्चुअली मेड फ्रॉम नेचुरल वुल. बिकॉज जैसे हमने देखा कि जो प्योर सिल्क होता है दैट इज़ वेरी कॉस्टली, सिमिलरली जो नेचुरल वुल होता है दैट इज़ ऑल्सो वेरी कॉस्टली. दैट्स वाई वी एड सम काइंड ऑफ सब्सटेंस इन दैट, इन द प्योर वुल, एंड दैट सब्सटेंस इज नथिंग बट acrylic, okay. So the shawls, sweaters, blankets that we wear during the winter season, na, that are made up of acrylic, okay. Though they appear to be wool, but they are not wool, they are acrylic, okay. These are prepared from another type of synthetic fiber which is called as acrylic, okay students. Acrylic is cheaper than wool. The acrylic that we use na is actually cheaper than wool. That's why we prefer to use acrylic in place of pure wool, okay. Now वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वन डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ यूजिंग अ सिंथेटिक फाइबर. वॉट इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ यूजिंग अ सिंथेटिक फाइबर? इट इज़ दैट इट कैन कैच फायर वेरी ईजीली. ओके, द सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स कैन कैच वायर्स वेरी कैन कैच फायर वेरी ईजीली एंड दिस कैन बी डिजास्टरस. इट इज़ वेरी रिस्की टू वेयर सिंथेटिक फाइबर when we are doing something related to fire. That's why our mothers, while they are cooking, they do not they avoid to wear synthetic fibers when they are cooking. Okay, so this is one of the basic advantage of using a synthetic fiber. Okay, that's all for today's session, students. Thank you.